Hi guys and girls, I'm just going to shade this. I think you probably like to see this being shaded. It's the kind of thing I would have liked, so I'm just going to do a little. I probably won't do this for very long, but you'll get an idea. So I'm using a Steve Lindsay 123 degree graver. It's what they call the calligraphy one, the blue template, and just shading. So this is a mandala, and it's got an eye in it. I like things with eyes in it. I don't know why. And so they're a good opportunity. Someone actually showed me he'd use the same design. So I think I got this off of a vector thing, or a tattoo thing it might have been. But I don't follow the exact design. Just use their leaves. Let's call them leaves as a template. And then do some I could have varied the shading there, but so you've got a good opportunity to practice shading. And then I just done some, I don't know, what would you call it, like haloed around each one, and then just a pattern there. So they're a good opportunity. You can experiment with patterns, and you've got a kind of a thing that you need to repeat over and over again, and that's the only way you're going to improve your engraving. Do the same line 1,000 times, and then once you've done it 1,000 times, you'll do it without thinking, unless you've got I've got this nerve thing in me right arm, and it kind of makes me flinch every now and again, so I don't engrave for that long at a time. But I can actually do this. I'm gonna do my left hand now. So this is changing over to my left hand. So and it's quite an interesting disappointing that I can't use my right hand, but so much. But using my left hand, you can still use it for shading. And it's like learning to engrave again, so it's kind of interesting. So you have to be careful if you're using both hands. You have to be careful to get the same effect, but once you get into the routine, it's not that bad, and you have to hold your concentration that you you do the same line with your left hand, your right hand, but shouldn't be a problem for most people, because they'll be able to use the same hand. So I'm just out. I did this a couple of times actually. I've gone over it, but so I started off with a laser printer transfer, and when I'd done it, I sanded it all with an 80 grit 3M diamond, one of these. Just to give it a texture and round everything off. It's not, I wouldn't recommend it actually, because I'm re-engraving everything, but it's for an effect I want. So just, it's an experiment really, but I think it's gonna work. I'll mention it. I'll do a proper video when it all comes, when I'll get a solution. But I think the nerve damage in my arm is caused by engraving. So it was partly I was holding my hand in a bad position, and also it may have something to do with the vibration of the tool. There's a thing called vibration white finger, or the I don't know what it stands for, HAV, hand something vibration or something. And so it's a recognized industrial injury that if you use a vibrating tool for too long, it can cause some damage to nerves in the hand or some blood vessels or whatever. So just initial thing, there's some memory foam, and I've changed it, I put a different spring in the handpiece. What you got to watch is really high power. I love to use this, not so much now, but I used to love to engrave on a high power. So higher than that, so the whole thing was shaking. So you can't avoid it to a certain extent, no matter how you pad the handle up, because the graver is going forward and your hand is going backwards thousands of times an hour. So you have to be aware of that, and you have to, if you notice any, right, I'll engrave, this is my right hand now, so I'll engrave my right hand until this thing happens. It seems to be getting better, but it got so bad I couldn't engrave at all. I couldn't even pick up a pen and write for more than 10 seconds. If your wrist goes funny, don't macho it out and keep going. Take a day off. Because basically I did engraving every day for about 3 years. Not for maybe a couple of hours a day, but that's probably not the best idea. Ah, now see that thing? I can't actually put the graver where I want it. It could be a hand dystonia. That's a writer's cramp. So it might be a few things. But I think it's something to do with my ulna nerve, not carpal tunnel, because they're different fingers. So right, that's all I'll just talk about that. So I made these up as I've gone along, but then once you've done one section, you can use your first one to copy on the others. So you don't have to plan too much out with this kind of thing. You just need to a symmetrical design. So I'm using my left hand now. So I've got much better accuracy and speed with my left hand. It's just not as enjoyable to engrave with your left hand. I think what happens when you change hands, you change eyes. Because I use a microscope, I can close one eye or the other. And that's, or you're using the wrong eye for that hand. I think that might have something to do why it's not as comfortable to engrave your left hand as it is your right hand. But, So I've lowered the power a bit and I've increased the speed. So rather than a heavy cut, I've gone for a lot of lighter cuts, so the vibration isn't bad. So back to my right hand. So there is quite a fun advantage if you want to do a drawing, because part of the reason my wrist got bad is I used to contort my wrist so I could see that what I was engraving up the right way, which is a bad way. Your wrist, right, so let's I'll demonstrate. Right, so imagine you're looking at the let me do it this way. Right, I'm going to twist the camera around so it's almost the same view as where it's not exactly the same view, but right, so if that's you're looking at, say you're looking through a microscope or you're looking at your work, you want the graver at this position. I kind of, because I wanted to see the drawing in the correct orientation, I would twist my hand around and have the graver in that position, and it puts a lot of tension on your wrist. And I used to hold that there for hours and hours and hours, and I've got a thing vibrating on the knuckle, like the shock is going back into the knuckle. So it was quite a stupid thing to carry on doing, but I did it anyway. I learnt my lesson. So I'm spreading the word. I'll do it a bit more official when I'm seeing a chiropractor and all that, and hopefully when it's all better I'll discuss position and things like that. If there's anyone who knows, I mean, we're sitting at a microscope, it's quite a good position you'd think, but you do get a lot of tension in your back, and obviously it's caused me some discomfort. So if there's anyone who really knows, like you Google how to sit at a desk and you find different conflicting information, so you don't know what's what. But, I think actually to lean back a bit, like you can set up the scope, and when you use a scope you can actually move your head away from the eyepieces, and it ends up you're like looking through a little keyhole, but it's still okay to engrave. Like I can see that, like imagine that's through my eyepiece, I can see that, but it's nice and bright, so it's like a little, right, so I can peer through my eyepiece and I can move away, I can move in and out and I can still see, but then I hold my back at a much better position. So there's a thing, and when I lean back I seem to be able to control my right arm a little bit better, so I'm hoping that's part of the solution. But if you're starting out, I wouldn't worry that the tool and all that, I wouldn't worry that so much, because no, not many people are going to engrave as much as me, so I've took it to the took it to the limit. So you get the same vibration. It's no, I don't think it's any particular thing with a homemade machine, but you get it's the same effect no matter what power assist you're using. It's still an oscillating piston, so it's something you need to think about. But definitely, I'll show you what I used to do. Right, so I would never have it on that lower power. In fact, I've changed the piston. I've put a different piston in it. And so normally, I'd have it something like that. Like, you see that? You can actually see the shaking now. So see there? So there's even vibration on the outside of the tool, and that's going into your hand, and it's going into your blood vessels and all that. You're basically ultrasonic in your wrist for 8 hours a day. So that macho thing, I've got it, I think most men have got it, is if something goes wrong, you keep going. It's not really a good thing. That's for when we was cavemen. We had no doctors or anything, but now you need to stop, take a break and address it. And then you can get back to work. So right, so I'm shading. Let's talk about shading then. So I'm just it's a Steve Lindsay 123, not really polished, but about a 2000 grit. I've sharpened it too, and I don't go quite a large hill. Straight lines, the hill don't really matter. You're not going to be curving it. So, and I'm just you'll be able to see that quite nicely. Oh, see there's slight flit, there's slight hesitation in my hand. So I presume you develop a steady hand, but if your hand isn't steady, you may need, it may be the reason why your hand isn't steady. So you would never even notice if you had what's wrong with my wrist. You wouldn't really notice it unless you was engraving, because it's not something that you'd stop you doing anything else. Right, left hand. Right, I won't do it. It's a bit awkward with the camera, but I'll just I just do this little bit and it's done. It's not the best here, because I've actually I got the camera in such a position I have to kind of engrave under the camera. Oh, I'm giving up. Right, let's just show you that. And Cheers, guys. Thanks for following. I haven't done much lately, but hopefully we'll improve as it gets better. Cheers. Bye.